Let's just talk about answers that we all got. So what are some answers we got?
Nine.
You got one. Okay.
Yeah. I did get one too, but then I realized I did wrong.
Okay. The rightness and the wrongness is what I want to talk about mostly today. Okay? But for now, let's just gonna pose another one to you. Okay? I'm gonna pose a few of these to you. It looks like a date.
Yes.
2003 or something? I don't know. But 6 divided by 3. Okay, let's see what the consensus is here. What do we get?
Six.
Got six?
I got six.
Also got six. Anybody get anything else?
I got
negative one. Negative one would be kind of hard because none of these are negative.
You don't want to. Oh, I know what
I'm doing. I got 0.67.
Okay. Now, I'm going to guess that that is not quite exactly what you got. You actually got 0.66666 forever, right? And rounded to 0.67, which is equal to a fraction. What fraction is that equal to?
0.16.
What's that?
0.16. 1/6.
1/6? Nope, not 1/6.
6/10.
No, that'd be 6. That'd be 0.6 done. It's 0.6.
Oh my God.
6/7. That's 6/7. How about, do you know this one? You know what fraction that one's equal to? No?
3/9, I don't know.
It is 3/9. And it's, that means it's 1/3.
Yeah.
That is 1/3. Well, so what do you notice about 0.3 and 0.6? How much bigger is this than that? Well, it's also, how many times bigger is this than that?
2 times bigger.
2 times bigger. So I can multiply this by 2 and get 0.6 forever. So I should be able to multiply this by 2 and this by 2. And so it's actually 2/3. We got 6, we got 2/3. Do we still have -1 or did we change that?
I don't know. I don't know what. So many people can divide. Like, see, I just keep going like that. Stuck in like negative thing. You go into the negatives.
Go into the negatives.
So what I did is I went like 2 and 1, and then for some reason I went like that. Cause yeah, I went just down to the negative.
When
you can't do that because 3 can't go into 2.
Yeah, but, well, it doesn't go into negative.
Yeah, so that's why I was kind of screwing that up.
Okay. So we got 6, we got 2/3. Alright. Here's 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 times 5 minus 18 divided by 3. Okay, let's talk about some different results we've got.
20.
Anything different?
I don't know what's going on.
I got 105.
I got 2 1/3.
2 1/3?
Yeah.
Okay. 2 1/3. What'd you get, Harvey?
105.
105. Okay.
I can keep going, but I was like, no, that's way too big.
Okay. I'm going to put one more up there. Ask you, would it make a difference if I did this or this?
No.
It's a symbol that means the same thing. Divide, divide, they both mean divide. Okay. Okay, what are some answers we got for this one? 5 1/5. Well, that's as many people as we have. 5 different answers for 5 different people. Okay. Actually, the last one is the last one. I recognize it. All right, answers for this one.
288.
288.
288.
I just got two.
Two.
Four. Oh,
nice.
I'm just dividing this because I'm getting confused. I've got some.
Do this one in parentheses first, bro.
Yeah, that's what I did in the parentheses first, and then.
Yeah, and then you divide 48 by 2, and then 24 times 12.
So, here's the thing. This, I saw this problem for the first time 4 or 5 years ago. And actually, there's a whole, you know, the website Know Your Meme. Have you heard of that? Okay, they have it. Know Your Meme. Yeah, it's a division of ikenhascheeseburger.com. Have you heard of that one? No? Great. You guys familiar with the internet?
What?
Have you heard of it?
What?
Have you heard of Know Your Meme?
No.
You heard ikenhascheeseburger.com? All right. Well, whatever. Know Your Meme is just if there seems to be some kind of a meme, you know what a meme is, right?
Sure.
A meme is just kind of like a big popular thing that most often is taken and then changed a little bit and put back out there in a different form, right? Kind of like the
kind of like a remake of a song.
Huh?
Like a remake of a song.
Not so much a remake of a song, but it's like a, what's that song that people were dancing to and putting on YouTube all the time? The Shake?
Shake It Off?
No.
Harlem Shake?
Harlem Shake?
Oh, yeah.
Where people would just kind of be standing in a room and somebody would start to dance and everybody's dancing.
And they kind of like bend back.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. That's a meme, right? That you can be. Just widespread. People are just doing it. Right? It catches on. So this actually became kind of a meme of its own right, spreading on through the internet. Okay. The first time I saw it, a YouTuber that I really like, who makes math tutorial videos, he posted the question in a video and just said, "Help me, I'm kind of stuck on this problem." And very soon afterwards, there were hundreds of comments, swearing, just hurt feelings and anger over what was the right answer to this question. Okay? It's this way. Calculator says it's that way, or whatever. Okay? So, you can see there's room for confusion.
Can we see the comments?
Huh?
Can we see the comments?
No, the comments were on the YouTube video. I can't remember where the YouTube video is. It's years and years in the past. I don't even remember what it's called. But here we are, I'm asking you the same problem. You're getting the two different answers that people were getting then, okay? So let's try and clear that up.
Want to know a good video to watch on YouTube?
Address why that's happening. Do I want to know a good video?
Yeah, just like watch on YouTube sometime.
Okay.
It's why I love school, but, or wait, no, why I hate school but love education.
Why I love education?
No, why I hate school but love education.
Oh, is it a song?
No.
I'll try to remember.
This guy just kind of like says a 4-minute speech and it's actually pretty cool.
TED Talk?
No.
Okay.
That's like just something.
I'll try to look it up before next time we see you.
Alright.
Alright. Now I'm gonna have you do this again, but I'm just gonna throw some symbols in there. And I wonder if we might get exactly the same answer as every one of us. Okay. So I'm gonna put parentheses around here. There are already parentheses around these,
yeah,
and then I guess I could put parentheses around the whole thing, but that's a little bit redundant. Right? That's what I'm going to put the parentheses around those two numbers. Now let's see what we come up with and see if it's all unified. So what do we get?
Nine.
Anything else?
Yeah, nine.
Alright, so we all got nine that time? Nobody got anything different? Okay, let's look at the next one. I'm going to put parentheses around these two, and then I guess I can put parentheses around that. But again, I'm just kind of repressing the whole thing, kind of redundant. Let's see what we wind up with this time. So what do we get?
Six.
You got six? Okay. Six again? just walk me through how we got 6.
6 divided by 3.
Okay, so inside these parentheses, 6 divided by 3?
2.
So this is 2. And then, well, that's what was inside the parentheses, and what we have here is divide by 3. It's 2/3. Alright. So that one turned out not to be it. You did your answer right there. Okay. Let's go on to the next one. I'm going to put parentheses here. Parentheses here. Parentheses again, I'm going to put parentheses here, then here, then here, 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 and that's it. Alright, so first time around we get 5 different answers. Now what answers are we getting this out of? 42, 50?
Yeah.
50. So only 2 different answers? Not 5 different answers, just 2. Better, okay. Let's talk about why we're getting these different answers. It's most likely the issue, okay? And like I said, I want to talk about that right and wrong. Is one thing right and is another thing wrong? Now, should there be, let's go back to the first one. When I put parentheses where I put parentheses, should there be any way to get 2 different answers? I mean, like, when I get all done, is it possible to get 2 different results at the very end? Shouldn't be, right? The issue here is the reason why some people get, some people get 1 and some people get 9 if I don't put parentheses, is this thing we call the order of operations, right? Now, what is with that PEMDAS thing? What is with the order of operation? What is it?
Parentheses, multiplication, division, addition, and subtraction.
Okay, so where does it come from?
Yeah. Egyptians. Oh, I don't say that.
Egyptians?
Egyptians?
Oh, yeah, that's a good guess.
Aliens?
Huh? Said PEMDAS, that's the way it is.
I don't know, he's smart.
Maybe. Okay.
You're the teacher.
It's true. Teachers ask questions.
So let me ask you a question.
Okay.
What does it stand for?
What stand for?
PEMDAS. What does PEMDAS mean?
All the words you said were correct for people who use that abbreviation. I mean, I've heard physics, excuse me, Sally. Then there's like this argument that breaks out. This is what the arguments are online. For 6 divided by 2 times 1 plus 2. Right. Arguments go like this. It's PEMDAS. PEMDAS. Okay. So, well, look what comes first. Multiplication comes first. This is the argument. I'm not saying this is right or this is wrong. I'm saying this is what people say. Multiplication comes first. So multiply these first. Do parentheses first. There's no exponents. You don't have to worry about that. Multiplication comes first. So 6 divided by, well, this is 3. So 2 times 3 is 6, and 6 divided by 6 is 1. That's the rationale behind that. Then other people say, no, you're mistaken. Multiplication and division, you're just working from left to right. It's not saying multiplication is first, division is second. It's just saying they're next. Those two things are before addition and subtraction. So if division comes first, do division first. Okay, so if you do division first, 6 divided by 2 first, right? Then we'll do the parentheses. I don't think anybody's confused about parentheses. If something's in parentheses, then put those numbers together. 6 divided by 2 is 3, and 3 times 3 is 9. So we come up with these two different answers. And the argument that ensues, right, who's right and who's wrong, becomes about this abbreviation, this acronym, PENDAS. Right? But again, where does that come from?
Mathematicians.
I would hedge a good bet that, it comes from mathematicians. Why would mathematicians want something like this?
Maybe easier.
What's
easier? Easier to remember. Or
make what easier to remember?
Make it easier to solve the problem or equation.
How does it make it easier? What was hard about it before?
Like going in order and like use that order for each one. So instead of just like jumping all around on each problem, you have an order for each problem. So
okay, an order.
That's why I call it order of operations.
Right? Each of these things, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, exponents, parentheses, not really an operation, but all these things, most of them are operations, and there's an order in which we do those operations, and that's why it's called the order of operations. But where did that order come from? Where did parentheses first come from? Exponents first come from? Multiplication and division first come from? Where did it come from?
Number.
It came from a number? There was a number once upon a time. Order of operations. I'm not sure that's a very fleshed out story. It's got a beginning and an end, a big gap in the middle. Where does that order come from?
How about we look it up?
Whether this is the order, or this is the order, is one order right and one order is wrong?
Yes.
Mathematically right and mathematically wrong?
Yeah.
Which one?
That one.
That one's correct?
Wrong.
And this one's right? Why?
Because we did an order of operations for that problem, and that one we just kind of went on our own. I don't know.
Well, it comes down to...
Somebody else want to help me out?
Just follow the PEMDAS, then you would have to...
Wait!
Yes, you have to do multiple first before you do.
Okay.
I don't think either of them are actually.
You have to
add parentheses.
Do left or right,
right?
Well, when we add parentheses,
yeah,
then there should only be one right answer, right?
Yes.
Because the order is not in question. I know exactly which order I should do this in. Because I made it clear by putting what? Parentheses. Right?
Okay.
So if I put parentheses there should be no question, no ambiguity. That's it. That's what we're supposed to do, because that's what the person who wrote this down is saying with parentheses. Okay. So why then would I want to not have parentheses and instead have this order? Why would I want to not have parentheses?
Because those get messy.
Because it takes up a lot of time and ink. I often say that a mathematician is a person who just wants to use as little ink as possible. It seems that it motivates a lot of the notation and things like that in math. We don't want to write more than we need to write. So we get rid of all these parentheses and we say, why are we putting all these brackets and parentheses around things when we can just agree to an order? Okay?
Exactly.
So this order...
Instead of people doing it different ways.
Yes.
And
exactly.
Then getting the wrong answer and getting fights. punching people. And yeah.
So, it's like this ruler, right? If I measure something and call it 20 inches.
Okay, and then I measure something in centimeters and call it like 80 centimeters, right? Is that what you're trying to get to here?
No. I'm saying that if I call it 20 inches and then I call my friend on the East Coast and say, oh, this thing was 20 inches, he gets his ruler out and he measures 20 inches and he gets the same length, right? All rulers are, should be standardized, and we all just agree. This is the thing I wanted to point out. It's kind of a funny thing. We all just agree to do things a certain way. Then it becomes, years later, people are arguing about what's right and what's wrong. It's not right or wrong, right? It's either
right.
Following the agreement or it's not. We just have to make clear what the agreement is. Okay. So it's kind of a funny thing. People will argue so much about who's right and who's wrong, and they're arguing over just an agreement. Okay? And until that agreement is clear, it's like saying, well, my ruler says 14, and my ruler says 75, they might be the exact same thing. It's just that 14 and 75, what? We haven't agreed to anything. Okay? So, the agreement. So what we have to do is straighten out the agreement that at least this class is going to make, right? And I'm pretty sure all the other teachers in this school have made, and most people around the world have made, it seems like there are some people who teach that multiplication comes first always, and division comes next, addition comes first always, and subtraction comes next always. Okay? And that's not how we're going to agree to do things. Right? So our agreement is to do things in the way that I put parentheses around all of these problems. Okay? It looks more like this. Same letters, pretty much the same order, but when I put it vertically, the way that I'm writing it here kind of shows you that I want multiplication and division, not for one to be before the other, but for them both to come before addition and subtraction and to come after exponents. See the difference there? We got multiplication and division on the same level, in the same rung in the order. Okay, and we're just going to work from left to right. If division comes first, work it first. If multiplication comes first, work it first. So the order I'm following would be the same as putting parentheses around the division, because the division comes first and the multiplication comes second. Okay, so we'll do the multiplication and division from left to right. And same with addition and subtraction, do it from left to right. Okay, so in this case, here's two divisions, a divide and a divide. I'm going to work them from left to right. Do this division first, I get 2, and then divide by 3 next, and, well, I guess I could write 0.6 repeating, or I could just say it's the fraction 2/3. Okay. To divide 3 by 3 first, 3 divided by 3 is 1. To get that 1, well, I have to violate the agreement that we made. Okay? It's not that you're doing it wrong, you're just not doing it the way that we agreed. Does that make sense? Okay. I like to, as often as I can, not make people feel like they're right or they're wrong. They're just doing it a different way. We agreed to do some other way. We need to do it some other order. Okay? So, here, with me, if you follow the order that I'm going to follow, I expect you to follow so that we can all be on the same page and I don't have to use a bunch of parentheses, we get 2/3 there. Divide from left to right. 6 divided by 3 first, that's 2, divided by 3 again, we have 2/3. Here again, order like this. This problem originally didn't have, like, the way it looks right now, I don't have any need for any of this, right? It's just all parentheses. I have coupled numbers together, so there's no question what's supposed to be done first. The only way that I can deal with this parentheses is to do the operation that's in there. Now it's just a one number, and I can combine it with another number. But as it is, when we take all of the parentheses away, don't want to do that. I guess we're just kind of stuck. If I don't want to write all of these parentheses down, we just have to agree on this order here. And the parentheses reflect that order. No parentheses to start with, no exponents, multiplication and division. So I group any multiplications and divisions from left to right. When I work from left to right, the first multiplication I see, 4 times 5. Okay. The next multiplication or division that I see, I skip that subtraction. Okay, so this is the next multiplication or division that I see, so I do that next. All right. And then I work addition and subtraction from left to right. I add the 1 and the 2. There's another addition, so whatever 1 plus 2 is, I add the 3 on there. Okay, whatever that is, I'm going to add that to 4 times 5. Right? I'm going to do that first. As opposed to doing 3 plus 4 is 7, I wouldn't do that. That would not be in the order that we offered, or that we agreed to. Okay. So this 4 times 5 is 20. And when if I were to put the parentheses around these things myself, I would be able to see that I could do this 4 times 5 and this 18 divided by 3, I could do it at the same time. It's not going to affect the answer, right? And so I can say minus, well, 18 divided by 3 is 6. Okay, so that's taken care of. This is taken care of. So I get, just write the rest of this stuff. Okay, so 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 20 minus 6. And now it's all addition and subtraction. We took care of all that multiplication and division. 1 plus 2 plus 3, 6 plus 20 is 26, minus 6 is 20. When we square away what order we're supposed to do it in, we should arrive at the same answer altogether. So now we have exponents involved. So we're going to do that exponent first. Okay. Here's a common mistake. 3 times 4 squared becomes 12 squared. Right? Now, if we didn't have an order of operations, there'd be no reason why this couldn't be right. See what I'm saying? It's an agreement. It's not a right or a wrong. It's an agreement. We agree. The thing we're agreeing to here is that I want you to take this 4 to the exponent of 2 first, okay? Then multiply it by 3. And if we agree to that, then I don't have to put parentheses around stuff and make it really obvious what I want you to do. We just agree to an order. Okay. So first we're going to take 4 to the second power. Right? Then we'll multiply 3 times 16 and total to that. Then this is addition right here. We're going to add, right? These parentheses here. We're going to add 15 divided by 5 is, that's 3 times 3, right? I'm coming through multiplication, division from left to right. Division first because it's left. And then multiplication. Okay. So 3 times 3, I'm going to subtract 7. Okay. I'm not going to do 16 plus 3 because, well, that's not the agreement anymore. Okay, so not 16 plus 3, but first 3 times 16 is 48. 3 times 3, I'm going to add that on, that's 9. I'm going to subtract 7, 48 plus 9, 50.
You should know I don't
7 minus 7, 50. Right? Or did I do that wrong?
That looks think? Right.
That's right. I think we only had one person have 50 right there. And you have 50
yeah,
party?
Yeah,
50. 50. It would appear you follow the order the way that we agreed to do the order of operation.
Yeah.
Okay? Now, this one, the one that was on the test that I just gave out to you, the one that caused so much controversy on the internet, okay?
Is
it about the right answer or the wrong answer? No, it's not about the right answer or the wrong answer. It's about the thing that I'm trying to communicate to you with the symbols that we have to use and the agreement that we made. I want you to do multiplication and division from left to right, addition and subtraction from left to right. One has priority over the other. Parentheses and exponents for those things, multiplication, division, and subtraction. So these are the two answers the internet came up with over and over and over and fought about. Okay? Which one should we get if we follow the order that we just have discussed? How you guys did this, and somebody got 288, somebody got 2.
288.
You get 288 if you follow the order that we agreed to. If we follow from left to right, well, I guess we could do parentheses first. Okay, we can do that. Now 9 plus 3 is 12, so 48 divided by 2, I guess we'll just put parentheses there, times 12. So we did parentheses, now it's down to, you know, it's our exponents, no exponents, so we get down to multiplication and division, left to right. This division comes first, it's on the left, so we'll do it first. 48 divided by 2, 24, times 12. All that's left is 48 times 12, or 24 times 12. 24 times 12 is 288. Order of operations. Following that order that we agreed to, we'll all come up with the same thing. Now that order also is important when we are talking about algebra, right? We're talking about expressions with numbers represent, or letters representing numbers. That's what algebra is. Okay? So, wonder how we do 5x. Can I simplify this at all?
Step.
Just sometimes there's a point where you just say, well, that's simple as it can get. Can't get these.
A little y or an x.
That should be an x. Clean this expression up, then what does it look like?
Yeah.
Is there any, can I combine anything or put anything together?
So the apps, you can actually put all of them together because they all have x at the end.
Okay, so I can put these together?
Yeah. And
get what? 10x to the fifth, you're saying?
Yeah, like that.
Okay. And then I guess we still have this left over?
That would be, once you set it. Sorry.
Seven. Let's even look at a simpler problem. That much. Let's look at a simpler problem, like x squared plus x to the third. Can we put those together?
No.
Yes and no. Yes or no, is it? Which is it?
You can put those together because there's nothing with x, it's just 1. You're just saying now let's do the...
A 1?
Yeah, it's just 1.
1x squared, 1x to the third. Okay.
Add them together, like normally, except you're combining the squares and just get like...
So what's my final answer then?
Well, it's just x to whatever power. It's x to like the fifth power then, but it's still just...
X squared plus x to the third is x to the fifth.
Just have five ones there. You just have five x's there, but since x doesn't go with anything, it's just x except to the fifth power.
Okay, so x squared plus x to the third, you say is x to the fifth.
Yeah, unless you have like the number next to it, and then that x can, that x to the third power can't really go into that now because it's done like.
So x squared plus 2x to the third, now you can't put together?
Never mind, I just realized what I did. You can put those together still because it still equals x. It's just 1, so it doesn't make a difference. It's adding to the powers now.
So what would be 2x to the fifth? 3x to the fifth?
No, I think it's 2.
so that's one thing. This to the third power is 2, this is 2 times x to the third power. Right? Order of operations says, parentheses, exponents first.
Yeah.
Exponent. What does this exponent belong to?
Dx.
Does it belong to the 2? The 2 is being multiplied by the x to the third. So first it's x to the third, so that's its little thing. We're multiplying that by 2. So can I take 2 to the third and get 8?
No, you can't.
That's a separate thing. Let's talk about this one first. Okay, x squared plus x to the third is an x to the fifth. Who agrees that it's x to the fifth? The fifth? Be the first person. Okay. Those of you who don't agree, what is it then? What is x squared plus x to the third?
Equals x squared to the x cubed.
X squared to the x?
Plus x.
Oh, plus. X squared plus x cubed.
Can't do anything with it.
You're saying it just has to be the way that it is?
Yeah, they're not the same powers.
Okay. Well, why is that a problem?
Well, they have to be on the same level in order to be added together.
They are in a very literal sense in different dimensions. They could not be combined by adding them together. They're two different things. But let me show you why it's most importantly not x to the fifth. Okay. So let's just erase those ones, even though that is true, they are, it is 1x to the third and 1x squared. Let's imagine maybe that it is x to the fifth, okay? Let's start back up here though. What's x squared mean?
X times x.
X times x. Okay, then we're going to add something to that, right? What are we adding to it? We're adding x cubed. What does x cubed mean?
X times x.
Even though it takes a long time to say, we still say it. And x times x times x. What's x to the fifth mean?
X times x times x times x.
Times x times x times x times x. Now, do you see 5x's here? You see 5x's here?
Yes.
Okay. These 5x's are being
multiplied together.
These 5x's are not being
multiplied together.
Right. These three are being multiplied together, these two are being multiplied together, but then we're taking that group of three, we're just adding them together. Right? So just adding them, I would have to change this addition to a multiplication. Can that happen?
No.
So we at least know that x squared plus x to the third is not x to the fifth. X squared plus x to the third is not the same as multiplying 5x's by each other. It's the same as multiplying 2x's times each other and 3x's times each other and adding them together. Right? So, well, what's the result? Can we add those together? Okay. The answer is no, we can't. It's, you know, we use this term a lot, like terms. They're not like terms. Can't be added together. Well, I guess this is like a group that's being multiplied together, it's a group that's being multiplied together, and we're trying to add them together. To add them together to say, like, maybe that's 2 of something, it would have to be 2 of a thing, of something, right? Let's use the analogy of, like, an apple, if that's an apple, and an orange. Can I say apple plus orange? Can I say 2?
No.
Is 2 of something? It's an apple and it's an orange. If I look in a paper bag and you ask me what's in there, I say an apple and an orange. But if there's an orange and an orange, what could I tell you is in the bag?
Two oranges.
Because it's the same thing. So I can just group them together and say there's 2 of them. But these are 2 very different things. This is the thing that is an x times an x. This is an x times an x times an x. They're 2, they're as different as apples and oranges. Okay? We can think of this x squared as a square that's x by x. Right? A square that's x by x. Does that make sense? X by x. X times x is x squared, so the inside of this would be x squared. So let's use that same logic to talk about x to the third. How can I represent x times x times x in a similar kind of way.
You draw a box.
A box.
Not like a square.
So here is a square, it's laying down. X by X by X. We go into a third dimension. And that's why they are in different dimensions. So there is a cube that is x by x by x. The inside of this is, the volume of this thing is x cubed. So here we have an area, here we have a volume, an area plus a volume. Is that something? Can I add an area to a volume?
Yeah, sort of.
If I add this area to this thing, I'm going to be adding to the area. I'm not going to be adding anything to the volume. I'm not going to be changing the volume in any way.
Right.
So, of course, I can't add this area to this volume any more than I can add an apple to an orange. Okay? They're not the same kind of thing. Okay? So that was a bit of an aside. We cannot add these together. But what we could do, if I have x squared and x to the third, how could I get that to be x to the fifth? What x squared is, it's two x's multiplied together, three x's multiplied together. What can I do with those so I get five x's multiplied together?
Well, because there's no plus sign in there, you can add them, you can multiply them together.
Multiply them together, not subtract them, not add them, not divide them, multiply them. Because what I'm really doing is I'm just kind of continuing a string of multiplying. Multiply, 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 multiply. X times x times x times x times x. That's just five x's. 5x's multiplied together. Now, we have this one up there, 2x cubed. 2x cubed. Can this somehow become 8x? Or 8x? Just 8x, or would it be 8x cubed?
No.
So 2x cubed is the same as 8x?
No.
This would be a violation of the operations that we agreed to, okay? We agreed to do exponents first, then multiplication. That's what's involved, multiplication and exponents, okay? I can't take this 2 to this exponent, because this exponent, what I'm wanting you to do is take x and raise it to the third power, okay? What I'm saying is, that's the order that I want you to follow. If I put parentheses around it, do you think that you're supposed to take 2 to the third power?
Yeah.
Is that?
And then you're still multiplying x and 3. Multiplying it by 2. Never mind.
Let's, instead of x, let's put a number in there. 2 times, instead of x, let's say it's 7. Now 7 is a little big to be cubing. Let's do 3. Times 3 to the third power. Should I take 2 to the third power? 9? Not quite 9. Well, more than
9. Oh, yeah, sorry. It's
27. 3 times 3 times 3 is 27. 9 times 3, 27. And then we multiply by 2. So the 2 ever interact with the third power? Does it ever get the third power applied to the 2 in any way?
No.
2 never gets multiplied by itself 3 times. Okay? So the same is true over here. But people get confused because there's an x there instead of a number. But remember, the order of operations still applies, even if it's an x. X is just standing in the place of a number. Once you put a number there, you can see you take the number to the third power and then multiply by 2. But you don't ever multiply 2 by itself 3 times. So this does not become 8x, it just is 2x cubed. That's it. If I ask you to simplify that, there's just no way. It is what it is. It's just 2x to the third. I can't really do anything until you tell me what x is. Right? Okay. Wow. Meant that to be a little aside. It got more aside than I thought it would get. Maybe we'll concentrate on that a little bit another time. The thing that I want you to come out with as far as order of operation goes, I I want you to know that this is the right way, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
No, it's the agreed way.
It's the way we agreed to. Okay. It's not right and wrong, it's agreed, and then, well, something else. We didn't agree on it, it's just something else. Question?
What is that? I'm sorry. That X represents
something like,
if somebody had like X equals 3 or
yeah.
like X equals 3 plus 5 or something like that,
uh-huh.
then for the exponent, do you do it to the X then, or do you do it to whatever it's being multiplied by?
So, can we use it? Would this work for the exam you're trying to? That would be fine. Okay. All right. And so you're saying x is equal to something.
Yeah, because sometimes they have it to like x equal 3 or something like that.
Yeah.
So what if it's that 3 is to the third? I mean, the x is to the third power. So then is that 3 also to the third power, or is it just the 2? Because then you're
I think it's
yeah, and you're supposed to multiply 2 no, times 3, but since it's the third power, does 3 have to be multiplied 3 times and just the 2? Or how does that work?
But I think what you're saying is you got this expression, and maybe the instructions say evaluate this for x equals 3. Like, what would this be if x were 3? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, like that.
This is exactly what you're talking about.
No, yeah.
Okay, so all we did was replace x, take x out, plug 3 in, right? And 3 now does whatever x was supposed to do. And according to the order of operations that we agreed to, well, we do the exponents first to the 3, right? The exponent has nothing to do with the 2 because it's just not part of that. It's not in that order. The order says take the 3 to the third power. Once you figure out what that number is, 27, then multiply by 2. Does that answer your question?
Sorry, just make sure you keep.
No, it's fine. If it wasn't clear, then it needed to be made clear. Okay. So yeah, that's the agreement. Not right, not wrong, just the agreement that we made. Right. Okay. Since we kind of have talked about this idea, let's see if I even let's add 3/4 and five-sixths. Okay, so let's add 3/4 and 5/6 and see how that goes. See if we remember what we're doing there. So, how do we add these two fractions? Anybody want to chime in there?
Five.
What's that?
Straight across.
Just add straight across. Okay, we get 8. Then 8.
Yeah.
Over
10.
8/10. All right. So who's?
10/10.
I'm gonna simplify 4/5. All right. Who agrees with that? Who doesn't agree with that? If you either agree or don't agree. This is a pretty binary thing. We got 4/5. 3 of you. 4 of you. All right, did you get 4/5?
No, I didn't try.
Oh, okay, so this is the trying approach. Not the best approach.
Well, I looked at it and I was like, okay, never mind.
Let's start back here. Let's just back up to where we said 8. Okay, so 3 plus 5 is 8. That's 3 plus 5 is 8. No tricks happening there. But when we say 8, we're saying 8 of something. And just like here, we're saying 3 of something, we're saying 5 of something. Okay? 3 of what? What are the 3 of?
4.
Fourths. Yeah, there are 3/4. And there are 5?
6s.
5/6. 5/6. So I look in my paper bag and I say, I'm looking in there and you say, well, what's in there? I say, oh, there's 3/4 and there's 5/6. Would you then add those up and say there's 8 or something? There are 8/10. Let's look at it. Let's open up this paper bag and see what 3/4 and 5/6 looks like. Okay? Alright, so I cut it into 4 pieces, right? That represents what about this problem here? Well, okay, it has to do with the three-fourths. What part of the three-fourths does it represent?
All of it.
This looks like three-fourths? This is four-fourths, the way she looks now. Three of those pieces would be three-fourths. Okay. So this is the words. This four here is, we call it the size. Does that make sense? So if I had four of these size pieces together, I'd have what? How much?
One whole.
Okay, exactly. So, well, I don't have four of them, and they have how many?
70, no, three.
Three of them.
75% of them.
This is how many? How many that I have? Let's just shade in the ones that we have. Yeah? This one, and this one. Look inside the paper bag, an analogy I'm using. When I saw the apple and the orange there before, I'm seeing three-fourths. I'm also seeing 5/6. Okay, so here's what a sixth looks like. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of those sixths. Six is the size, meaning it takes six to make one whole. And I have 5 of them. Now let me just ask you this quick last question. Would you, if you're looking at these size pieces, would you try and say that there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 of them? If I had 3 apples and 5 oranges, are there 8 of something?
No.
No.
Well, there's 8.
Well,
there's
fruit.
Something you could have with apples. In order to combine them and say we have a collection of these, they need to be the same thing. We can't do it with apples and oranges, but we can do it with pieces of pie.
I know.